Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can host your Discord bots on Heroku for free. Now there are pros and cons to using Heroku versus other solutions. For example, I'm on the Heroku main page here, and if I go to pricing, I can then scroll down and we want to select free and hobby, which is $0 and up per month. Scrolling down, we then see other options. Here is the free plan, and this has 550 to 1000 hours per month. And there are around 730 hours in a month, and so if you do get the free plan, you are not going to have enough time for your bot to be online every single day of the month. In order to unlock the up to 1000 hours here, you have to add a credit card to your account. But if you do have a credit card, you can use this app for free. And if you don't, you can get 550 hours per month right here. And real quick, before we start, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below, or better yet, ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord server, and I'm sure someone will be able to help you there. So with that said, I'm going to scroll up, and I'm going to sign into my account. If you don't already have an account on Heroku, you can go ahead and make one. Okay, so now I am logged in. I'm going to come back to Heroku, but first we need to make sure that you have a GitHub account. So if I go over here, here's my GitHub account, and I'm going to show you how you can create a repository for your Discord bot. So if you don't already have a GitHub account, head over to github.com and make one. It'll be completely free. And then once you're on your overview page right here, you can click on repositories, and then here you can click on new. So we're going to be making a new repository here, which will hold information about your Discord bot. There's a couple reasons why you want to use GitHub. In this exact case, it's going to allow Heroku to access our code files, but there's more important reasons than that. Every single project you work on should be inside of its own GitHub repository. This can be a public repository where other people can access it, or a private repository where only you can access it and anyone you give access to. And GitHub is something called a version control system. It allows people to collaborate with you, but more importantly, it allows you to keep versions and backups of all of your code. So every time you make a change, you can then push that, which basically means upload it, to a GitHub repository. And then if something goes wrong, let's say your computer crashes and everything gets deleted, or you just make a mistake and you want to go back, you then have access to the previous versions of your software on GitHub as a safe place to store them. So I highly suggest that every project you make, even if you're working alone, you always have a public or private repository that you can use as a version control system. So I'm going to name mine warrenoffkeys-discordjs-tutorial. You can name yours whatever you want. And I'm going to make this a private repository. I'm then going to go down here and click on create repository. And so now we have this page here. This is going to give us some instructions on how to actually set up a GitHub repository within our project. Now at this step, you want to make sure that you have access to using GitHub on your machine. So you can just search git download, or you can go to git-scm.com, and here you can download GitHub for your own computer. So here I'm on Windows, so it's telling me to download for Windows here. And once you have this installed, which is just a typical installer where you press next a bunch of times, then you're going to be able to use the git command within your terminal. For example, if I type git, I press enter, we see a bunch of different options that I can use with this command. So now with that said, I'm going to go ahead and clear my console with control L. You can also type in clear, and that will also clear it. And then I'm going to go into VS Code, which has this project here that we made in the very first video. So my goal is to get this project deployed to a Heroku application for free. And so we first have to deploy this to GitHub, which will then allow Heroku to import our project's files. So there's a couple and very important things I want to talk about here. For example, inside of config.json, if you remember, we actually added our bot's token, which is used to log in. That is incredibly important that no one has access to that aside from you or people who are working on this project with you. So with that said, we do not want to send this file to GitHub, especially if you are using a public repository. If you are using a private repository, then that is up to you. So first, I'm going to show you how to do this with a private repository, and then I'm going to show you how to do this in a different configuration, assuming you want to use a public repository. Now, the second way I'm going to show you that I just mentioned will work either way with public or private, it's just a different configuration. So to get started, we need to initialize this project as a GitHub repository. So I'm going to expand my console here, and I'm going to scroll in a little bit. We can type git init, and this is going to initialize a GitHub repository within this directory. So if you press enter, and if I do ls-a, the dash a flag is essentially going to list all hidden files. So if we do that, we see .git right here. And so If I navigate into there using cd.git, I can do ls, and we see some type of information and configuration that we normally don't have to mess with, but this is just showing that this is now a GitHub repository. So I can use cd.dot to go back to the previous directory. We can use ls to confirm that we are now within this project here. And now our goal is to actually set up the GitHub repository that is created on github.com with this local GitHub repository that we just created. So going back into GitHub, we see these commands we can run. So we already ran git init. We now want to add our files. So if I run git status, we then see all these files here. We see config.json, index, node modules, and our package.json files. Now, like I previously mentioned, if you're using a public repository, you do not want to commit the config.json file, and I'll show you how to ignore that soon. But if you're using a private repository, you can go ahead and commit it if you feel comfortable with that. But either way, we do not want to commit node modules right here. This is something you never want to actually commit to your GitHub repository, because oftentimes those are going to be very large. So we are going to create a file called gitignore. We're just going to specify a list of files and folders to ignore. So going inside of here, I can right click and I can go new file. This will be called .gitignore. Make sure the dot is in front of it. That is important. And then in here, we can type whatever we want. I'm going to say node_modules, and I'm going to save this. Now, if I run git status again in my console, we no longer see node modules. We also see gitignore, which is fine to actually push to the GitHub repository. But the important part is that node modules, which was previously listed, is no longer there. So now we can go back to GitHub and we can follow this step right here. So git add, and it's saying to add whatever file we want. So we could say git add index.js, for example. And now if I run git status, it should now show index.js in green. There's an easier way to do this though. If you want to add all of the files that are in red, you could just say git add star. And then if I run git status, we are then going to see that all the files are now in green, which means that they are ready. The next step is to commit these files, which means that we are going to get them ready to actually push to the GitHub or upload to the GitHub repository. So I'm going to say git commit, and we can add in an optional flag here, so -m, and then this is going to expect a string within quotes. Here's where we send whatever message we want. So for example, let's say that we just added a new welcome message. We could say add new welcome message. Now, obviously that's not what we did, but that's just an example. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And typically your first commit is going to be whatever they say right here, is going to be first commit. So first commit. And now if I run git status, we don't see anything as ready to commit because it's already committed. Now, typically these last three lines, I like to copy and paste just to save some time. So git branch dash m master. I'm not going to go into too much detail what branches are because it's kind of out of the scope of this. I will eventually create some videos on this channel about GitHub. So now that we've ran that command, I can click on this and we can paste this in here. And then I can click on the bottom one. And you might be prompted to enter your username and password for GitHub. That's perfectly normal. I have mine configured where I have to enter a certain passphrase. So after I do that, it should then upload all of our files. And if I run git status, we see that it says that your branch is up to date with origin/master. Nothing to commit, working tree clean. This means that everything is up to date with the actual GitHub website. And if we refresh this page, we then see all of our files right here. This includes the config.json file. So I'm going to show you how to set up this using the config.json file in a private repository, which we see right here. And again, if you don't want to use a private repository, then I will be showing you how to configure this to not use config.json and to use something called an environment variable after we get this setup done. So that we have this, we can go inside of Heroku. I'm going to minimize this console, and we can click on create new app right here. Now we can create an app name. Mine is going to be Warnoff Keys, Discord.js tutorial. You can name yours whatever you want. Oops, the name must start with a lowercase letter, so I'm just going to do Warnoff Keys, Discord.js tutorial like that. And then it says that is available, and then you can choose a region. I'm going to select the United States, and then I'm going to click on create app. Now at this stage, we want to select a deployment method. Because we already have our code submitted to GitHub, we are going to select GitHub right here. It might ask you to connect your GitHub account. Go ahead and do that. And then at this stage, we want to go ahead and search for our repository, which in my case is Warnoff Keys Discord.js tutorial, spelled like that. So you would enter whatever one that you would use. So Warnoff Keys Discord.js, I can then click on search, and we see the repository right here. I can then click on connect. And now scrolling down, we want to click on enable automatic deploys. This means that whenever you push to your GitHub repository, which I'll show you how to do here in a second, that it will automatically rebuild your app on Heroku. So I can click on this, and then scrolling down, we can then click on deploy branch, which will make it so right now it is automatically going to take whatever is inside of the master branch and then move it into our Heroku app. And I'm not going to go into too much detail, but basically branches are like different categories or folders. You can have a master branch, which is typically tied in with your production environment, which is just a fancy way of saying whatever is alive for the users to actually see. In this case, that would be your Heroku deployment. A lot of the time you will see a development branch, which means that it'll just be code that is shared between you and your coworkers whenever you're developing new features, but not ready for the public yet. And you can have as many branches as you want, but by default, you always have a master branch. So going back, we can then click on deploy branch, which is going to take all of the code within the master branch, which is all of our code at the moment, and deploy that to the Heroku application. So here we then see some logs here, and then after a while, it's going to say that your app was successfully deployed. Now, if we click on view right here, it's going to try and load this as a website, and so it's not going to work. That's expected. We can go ahead and close that, and then we can scroll all the way up, and we can click on overview as a tab right here. Here we see all the latest activity, and we can also click on this more dropdown and click on view logs. So here we see the client is ready, which is going to be the same exact console log that we have right here, which means that our bot is working. So if I bring Discord onto the screen right here, we see that our tutorial bot is now online. Hey everyone, Alex here. I'm wanting to add in this part of the video because I forgot something when recording the original video. You have to make a very simple file within the root of your project. So you can do right click, new file, and you want to call this proc file with a capital P. Then you want to add in worker, colon, and then node, and then the path to your actual main application. In this case, it is index.js, so I can simply just say index.js. Then I can save this. And you want to make sure that this is pushed to your GitHub repository because this is going to be necessary for whenever you're going to deploy your Heroku application. Without this, it is going to assume that you are going to use some type of web server and it's going to give you some type of error where your bot will go offline after only 1 minute. So once you have this, we can then go into Heroku and you can go inside of your resources tab. And you would normally see this web right here, which will say npm start. You are then going to want to make sure you see worker right here, which will then say node index.js or whatever you put inside of your actual file. And you want to make sure that this is enabled. To do that, you can click on the pencil and you can disable the original one and then click on confirm. And then you can click on the pencil on the new one and enable it and then click on confirm. And so this will solve a problem that you're going to have later on while following this video. So I wanted to add in this quick part of the video because I forgot to do this throughout the original recording. So now I'm going to go ahead and remove our config.json file. So I'm going to comment out this line because we are going to try and not commit config.json to the GitHub repository. That also means that it will not exist on the Heroku application because it won't exist within these files right here. And if it doesn't exist here, that means whenever Heroku goes to pull these files, it won't have access to config.json. So we do need to remove or comment out line 3 because that will cause a problem if we're trying to import config.json without it actually existing. So I'm going to simply comment it out and then I'm going to go in and copy my token. Okay, so now I have my token copied. I'm going to go back into Heroku and I'm going to go into settings. We can go down to config variables right here, config vars. We can click on reveal config vars and we are going to get a key and value. So this key can technically be whatever you want. Typically, at a standard convention, we are going to have these be all uppercase. So I'm going to name this discord.js underscore token. And then I'm going to paste in my value and click add. So now I have that token set up there. And so now in order to access this within Node.js, now here on line 9, we are actually going to be using the token, but here we're accessing config.token and configuration doesn't exist anymore because we commented out on line 3. So I'm going to actually remove this and I'm going to say process. .env.discord.js underscore token. This is going to be the exact string that you typed into Heroku a few seconds ago right here. So whatever that is, you want to type this here, and Heroku will then pass this information into our bot, and we no longer have to have our config file uploaded to GitHub. So we can actually add that to our gitignore. We can say config.json, and now it is no longer going to be added inside of our GitHub file. So going into our console here, I can run git status, and we see git ignore and index.js. I can run git add star and then git status again, and we see that they are now green. Git commit dash m, we're now going to commit this to our actual repository. We can now say use process env instead of config JSON. And then we can run git push, which is how you're going to actually push this to your GitHub. Now, before I run this command, I'm going to minimize this, and I'm going to go inside of Heroku, going over to overview. Here under latest activity, we're actually going to see that it's trying to build information from the GitHub repository. So we can go back into here, and we can run git push and enter your username and password, or whatever it prompts you with, if anything. And then git status is going to show that everything is up to date. I can minimize this, and I can refresh Heroku here. And now we see these three dots here. You might have to refresh a couple times, and it says build in progress. So if I click on view build progress right here, you are then going to have some console logs that's going to show that it is automatically pulling the information or pulling the code from GitHub and then rebuilding the project and getting it ready to actually work. Now here we see build finished. And if I go into the logs, we now see the client is ready again. So now that this is going to use a environment variable, which is something that we access right here through process.env, which stands for environment, .djs token, which is the exact thing that I entered on the Heroku settings. And now if we go inside of our repository, we see that config.json is still here, but it is from 9 minutes ago. And so if you do have a public repository, you are not wanting to ever push config.json to your GitHub ever. You're going to only want to use the environment variables that we just set up within a public repository. Within a private one, it doesn't matter. And if you do accidentally commit your config.json to your GitHub repository, the easiest way to fix that is to just simply regenerate your bot's token, and that way that the whatever is inside config.json is not going to be valid anymore. And so that's it. This is how you're going to host your Discord bot within Heroku for free. Again, keep in mind that you are only going to get 550 hours for free without adding a credit card to your account. But that really is the only downside to using Heroku, especially if you're new and you're not comfortable with using a Linux server, which is what I previously explained how to use. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.